adjunct professor in the Department of Economics here at Queen's. Welcome to Macroeconomic Policy. In this course, we'll explore how government can help grow and stabilize the overall economy. The overall economy, it can be kind of intimidating. In this course, we'll clear away some of the fuzz and we'll eliminate a lot of the math. We'll focus on the simple relationships that undergird the economy. When overwhelmed by the details of a complex economy, it's helpful to imagine the simplest possible economy, the desert island with one survivor. What does it take for Tom Hanks or Robinson Crusoe to survive? Surprisingly, the first thing it takes is faith. Our sole survivor has to believe that there's hope. If they curl up and suck their thumb, it's all over. They have to believe that their work effort will pay off. Another thing that you need to survive economically is capital. And by capital, we can mean all kinds of things. Physical capital, like chairs and desks, fishing nets and knives. Human capital, like skills and health. Environmental capital, like a source of fresh water. And natural resource capital, like coconuts on the trees, fish in the water, and minerals. No matter how hardworking you are, if you don't have a critical threshold amount of capital, you cannot survive on the desert island or in the modern economy. When people defer gratification in order to protect their capital, we call that savings. Basically, instead of having a lot of fun now, they're denying themselves for the sake of the future. Instead of eating all the coconuts today, save some. In this way, we prepare for predictable hardships like old age and unpredictable hardships like sickness or storms. So it's simple things like faith, savings, and capital that make an economy strong. And the government and its central bank should keep those simple things at the forefront of their consciousness. I hope you'll enjoy exploring how government taxation and savings and how central bank money creation and exchange rate manipulation can work sensibly to make the economy better off.